when broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Where words come out from the depth of truth. Where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. Where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. Where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thought and action. Into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake.
Today, India celebrates its 72nd Republic Day. It's a day when the entire nation, with much enthusiasm and joy, commemorates that historic moment when India's constitution came into effect on 26th January 1950. On this joyous occasion, on behalf of the entire school management, let me wish each one of you a very happy Republic Day. A republic is a country in which the supreme power is held by the citizens. Preamble of Indian Constitution declares India to be a sovereign, socialist, secular and democratic republic and promises all its citizens justice, liberty, equality and fraternity. 72 years have passed since our country has become a republic. During these past years, great is the progress that our nation has made. However, it is good to introspect and see, has the dream of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation and the heroes of our freedom struggle, to establish a classless, cooperative, free and happy society become a reality? Facing the contemporary issues such as rising unemployment and poverty caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, human rights violations, corruption and farmers' protest, as India is moving forward, let us still dream of creating a better society. A society filled with peace and harmony. For every human cry we hear is an invitation to our commitment. Our dream of building a strong republic cannot be achieved unless we are united as enlightened citizens of this great republic and stand together united under the national flag and the constitution. Therefore, my dear Saint Marians, let us illuminate the path of others with our little act of kindness, patience, joy and generosity. We do not know what the year 2021 has in store for us, but what each of us and all of us can do is to commit ourselves a little more to take care of each other and of creation, our common home. I thank and appreciate the students of class 9B who, under the able guidance of Mrs. Kavita Pandey, made this wonderful effort of celebrating this day on digital platform. As we celebrate our 72nd Republic Day and salute our great nation today, let us pray for God's message of love, compassion and mercy fill our nation. Jai Hind.
A very happy Republic Day and a pleasant morning to all our dear viewers. With freedom in mind, strength in words, pureness in blood, pride in our souls, unseen in our hearts, we, the students of Class 9B, present before you a short prayer assembly on the theme Republic Day. Begin our assembly by connecting our souls with the Almighty by meditative movements and experience the divine love through a Sufi prayer dance.
सवेरा मेरे तन बरसे कचरा अंधेरा तेरी जाती ला सजरा सवेरा मेरे तन बरसे कचरा अंधेरा तेरी जाती ला अतरा मिला जो तेरे दर बरसे ओ मौला
and Republic State with the adoption of the Constitution on January 26, 1950, a salute of 21 guns and unfurling of the Indian National Flag by Dr. Rajendra Prasad heralded the historic birth of the Indian Republic on that day. Thereafter, 26th of January was recognized as the Republic Day of India and was declared a national holiday. Even before that, this date had acquired special significance. Having resolved to attain Purna Swaraj, our people had been celebrating Purna Swaraj Day on every 26 January from 1930 to 1947. That is why in 1950, we embarked our journey as Republic on the 26th January, affirming to the principles laid down in our Constitution. Since then, every year we celebrate our Republic Day on 26th of January.
The Constitution of India is the supreme law of the country. The document lays down the framework demarcating fundamental political code, structure, powers and duties of the government institution. The Constitution of India gives us right as the citizens of free democratic nation, but also put on us the responsibility to always adhere to the central tenets of our democracy. If the Constitution of India had the power to speak and share its feelings with us, then what will it say? Let us listen to it in its own words.
मैं संविधान हूँ, भारत का संविधान। आज मैं आपको अपने निर्माण की गौरव गाथा सुनाता हूँ। कुछ लोगों के लिए मैं नियमों में जकड़े चंद पन्नों की महज एक किताब हो सकता हूँ, परंतु अपने देशवासियों के लिए मैं अनुशासन, त्याग और बलिदान की जीती जागती मिसाल हूँ। जब आप मेरे रक्त प्राण, अस्थि मज्जा, स्नायु तंत्र से अवगत हो जाएंगे तो आप स्वयं समझ जाएंगे कि किसी देश के लिए संविधान के क्या मायने हैं। जहाँ तक मेरे निर्माण की बात है, यह एक घटना नहीं है, यह तो एक यात्रा है जिसमें कई पड़ाव हैं, अनेकों सहयात्री हैं और उनमें से हर एक सहयात्री का इस यात्रा को सफल बनाने में योगदान है। तो चलिए मैं आपको अपने निर्माण की यात्रा पर ले चलता हूँ। मेरे निर्माण में कार्यक्रम भारत की संविधान सभा की पहली बैठक 9 दिसंबर 1946 को हुई थी। 2 वर्ष 11 माह और 17 दिन के सतत मंथन के बाद 26 नवंबर 1949 को मेरा निर्माण तो हो गया, परंतु भारत की संविधान सभा के 284 सदस्यों के हस्ताक्षर 24 जनवरी 1950 को हुए और अंत में 26 जनवरी 1950 को मुझे भारत में अंगीकृत किया। मैं भारत को एक संपूर्ण प्रभुता संपन्न समाजवादी तंत्र निरपेक्ष लोकतंत्रात्मक गणराज्य बनाए रखने और इसके सभी नागरिकों को समानता, न्याय और स्वतंत्रता दिलाने में प्रतिबद्ध हूँ।
इतने प्रयासों के बाद भी मेरा देश मेरे स्वप्न को और स्वप्न पूरा न होने की पीड़ा को समझ न सका। मैं वास्तव में महज एक किताब बनकर रह गया और न्याय, समानता, स्वतंत्रता खोखले शब्द और भाईचारा एक क्रूर मजाक। मैं आज अपने सभी देशवासियों से यह पूछना चाहता हूँ कि मैंने तो स्वयं को आपके हवाले कर दिया, परंतु आपने क्या किया? धन के नाम पर हिंसा, जाति के नाम पर बंटवारा, संसद में मेरा अपमान और अपने हित के लिए मेरी मनचाही व्याख्या। क्या गणतंत्र दिवस पर मुझे याद कर लेने से आपके कर्तव्यों की इतिश्री हो जाती है? नहीं, मैं आज भी एक ऐसे भारत को देखने की आशा रखता हूँ जो मेरे बनने के उद्देश्य को न्याय दिला सके और जिसका हर एक नागरिक अपने देश के लिए स्वस्थ विचार रखे। मुझे उम्मीद ही नहीं, पूरा विश्वास है कि जिस दिन हम सब मिलकर इसे सच बनाने के लिए दृढ़ निश्चय कर लें, तो वह दिन दूर नहीं जब भारत विश्व में एकता की मिसाल रखेगा, जहां सब एक साथ आगे बढ़ेंगे। अब रात की दीवार को ढाना है जरूरी, ये काम मगर मुझसे अकेले नहीं होगा। लेके दिया उम्मीद का अब चल पड़ा हूँ मैं, आओ बढ़ाए हाथ करे काम ये मुमकिन।
Do you know what is the spirit and backbone of the Indian Constitution?
Yes, it is the preamble to the Indian Constitution. Some call it the soul of the Indian Constitution, while some call it the identity card of the Indian Constitution. It has also been called the political horoscope of the Indian Constitution.
We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign socialist, secular democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among all fraternity, assuring the dignity of individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In the Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this constitution.
Children play a vital role in nation building and developing human resources. As they are the future of our country, they have an effective role in the progress, prosperity, unity, and political stability of the country. They need to maintain their dignity, bright future, and lead the nation towards being a developed country. duties of a child towards a country are very important. Some of them are as follows.
Buying these local products will not only boost our country's economy, but also make India invisible and unstoppable. So let's become vocal for the local. Be Indian and buy Indian.
A P P L E. B for ball. B A L L. C for cat.
और आज बेटा पेपर कैसा है?
बहुत अच्छा है पापा, बहुत अच्छा है।
पर तुम मुझे देख के घबरा क्यों गए?
कुछ नहीं पापा, वो नेटवर्क की दिक्कत है ना।
अच्छा ठीक है, रुको अभी मैं देखता हूँ क्या प्रॉब्लम है।
नहीं नहीं पापा, मत देख के आइए, मैं मैनेज कर लूंगा।
ठीक है।
Good morning everyone and happy Republic Day to all my dear viewers. In this occasion when everyone is celebrating the Republic Day in form of cultural programs, speeches, prayers, pledges and many other things, I appreciate this small effort of class 9B for reminding everyone, especially students, of their significant role needed for the growth of our country. Thank you children. I also have a small message for you, my dear children and parents also. Dear children, always remember that wrong means can never lead you to the right result. In challenging time, you need to listen to your conscience. For that, you need to be emotionally very strong. Dear parents, you are the strength of the children. Don't just throw your children into the race of scoring good marks. Accept them the way they are. Accept their marks, whatever they score. Don't burden them or compel them to use wrong things. They do it because they don't want to see you sad. They do it because they love you. Thank you and happy Republic Day once again. Jai Hind.
Now let us join our hands, close our eyes and pray to the Almighty. Dear Lord, guide us in the road of life. Help our students to perform our duties. Give us the power to listen to thy eternal voice and choose between the right and the wrong. Invoke your blessings so that we grow to become an honest human being and a responsible citizen who is ready to contribute in the all-round development of our nation. Let the light of hope remove the darkness of fear.
Dear Lord, we pray you for our country, India, to work with integrity. May the leaders turn the bad fortune into a hope that we can still overcome our pains and reach at the uppermost level to acquire success and prosperity. Amen.
मैं जानता हूँ कोशिशें ये रंग लाएंगी, पाकिये पतन में बुलबुले फिर लौट आएंगी। भारत बनेगा विश्व का सिरमौर एक दिन, माँ भारती उस दिन जरूर मुस्कुराएंगी। एक सोच से हम देश को आबाद करेंगे, चूमेगा वो शिखर की सभी याद करेंगे। बलिदान व्यर्थ जाए ना खाते हैं ये कसम, मिलके रखेंगे आज तिरंगे की आन हम। फिर ना फीका पड़े अब रंग वो फलना है तुझे, ऐ मेरे देश अभी और सवरना है तुझे।
On behalf of Class 9B, take this opportunity to extend my heartfelt gratitude to our manager, respected Sister Marriott, and to our principal, respected Sister Lissy, for giving us the opportunity of putting up this Republic Day Assembly. I would like to thank our headmistress, Sister Renu, for her valuable guidance. I am thankful to our class teacher, Kavita Pandey Ma'am. It would have been impossible to present this assembly without her support and guidance. I am grateful to Anurag sir for the technical guidance. I would like to thank all our co-workers for being with us in the making of this virtual assembly. Last but not the least, I would like to thank all our dear parents for their cooperation and wholehearted support. Thank you.